If we look at the order of service, title of the message this morning is one of the most challenging facets of our lives. What, pray tell, might that be? I think it's the condition of relativity that each of us has. We commonly call that our relationships. But relationships, all of us have massaged and messed with what that means. We all have this idea that has been skewed by great relationships or terrible ones, disappointment, expectations. And I like to think of it as our condition of relativity. You know, Einstein had a theory of relativity, E equals mc squared. We've all heard of that. Who would like to stand up and explain that to us this morning and how, what significance that theorem has in our day-to-day lives? I'm sure it does. Anybody? I came up with a theory of relativity. You might like to follow along. Our purpose as human beings may consist of countless unique and complex facets. However, one of those facets must be simply relativity with our fellow inhabitants of this planet. That we can get our head around a little better, I think, than E equals MC squared. And I thought I came up with something profound, but turns out I wasn't the first to have thoughts along those lines. The next one is by FDR, back in the 40s. If civilization is to survive, we must cultivate the science of human relationships, the ability of all people of all kinds to live together in the same world as peace. Turns out he wasn't the first one to thought of that type of philosophy of relativity. Plato, Socrates, thousands of philosophers had very similar insight into the purpose and one of the necessary facets of our lives. So today I'm going to talk a little bit about relationships or our condition of relativity. And I'm not so much going to talk about a married relationship or a committed relationship, or we used to call it shacking up. I'm going to talk about the relationships we have as friends, as this community that we're part of, our working relationships. I think all of those relationships, yesterday in the wedding, part of the script that we use, it says, we aren't doing this to grow together. We're doing this to look out in the same direction. And if you think about relationships that you have with people you know, there's a commonality. I have musical relationships, and we think about the possibility of what we can create musically. These three people, four people, demonstrate that perfectly this morning. Wayne's not here. He's playing golf. Wayne has golf relationships. We have artists in now. They have a commonality with other artists, and they think about the creativity, and there's a positive faction to that relationship. One of the quotes on the order of service is, when you stop expecting people to be perfect, maybe you can begin to like them for just who and what they are. And most of our conditions of relativity, when we phrase it like that, we can look at objectively. But the minute we call it a relationship, oh, it's got parameters, and it's got design, it's got expectation, it's got disappointment, has rules. How can we all begin to relate to each other in a more positive, and sustainable fashion. I'd like to read some quotes, a couple of quotes that I think deal with this. Relationships are mysterious. We doubt the positive qualities in others, but seldom the negative. You will say to your partner, "Do you really love me? Are you sure you love me? Are you really sure you love me?" And you will ask this a dozen times and drive that person nuts. But when somebody is angry, you don't doubt it for a moment. The reverse should be true. We should doubt the negative in life and have faith in the positive. Doubt the negative in life and have faith in the positive. There's another quote. How would your life be different if you walked away from the gossip and verbal defamation? Let today be the day that you speak only the good you know of other people and encourage others to do the same. Just leave the negative out of the conversation. I need to paste that on a board that sticks right out in front of me all the time. I really need to work on that a lot. And maybe I'm not the only one in the room. Get so hung up, I think, on expectation, on this thing we call relationships. A couple weeks ago, I spoke about the most important relationship we can have is with ourselves. And I'll say again, we all could use some work enhancing that relationship, learning more about it, developing it. But when I look at people walking down the street, when I turn on the television, when I hear people in conversation, I'm absolutely positively sure that we all need to work on our conditions of relativity with each other. That song we sang this morning, all the different cultures, all the different belief systems, all the different lifestyles, they all, we're all in this together. Why should we always be focusing on the negative and the difference? Please ponder this as you start your conversations, as you consider your condition of relativity with other people, with your relationships with other people. It doesn't make any difference what you call it. I've talked about friendships, commonality, relationships. There's one that I have not spoken of yet this morning. I'm going to read another quote, and it mentions it right at the end. This quote is by A. Philip Randolph. Justice is never given. It is exacted, and the struggle must be continuous for freedom. Freedom is never a final fact, but a continuing, evolving process to higher and higher levels of human, social, economic, political, religious, and spiritual relationship. If we include our relationship with the divine, our higher self, our loving self, our compassionate, accepting self, if we include that and make that part of our friendships and acquaintances and relationships and conditions of relativity, our lives will be richer. Our lives will be different. the consciousness of our being will change, and others people's lives will be different and enriched and changed as well. The most important relationship we have is the one with ourselves. But that, too, and we include our relationship with Spirit, with God, with the Divine, that, too, is enhanced. Just some things that you might choose to ponder this week, and next week, and the week after. Our world needs us, folks. It's up to us. Nobody out there has a plan to fix it. We just simply have to do it. And that we shall. And if you need some inspiration, just tap into your divine imagination, and I know and I trust it'll come to you. And so it is. Let's stand up and sing Imagine.